Recent advances in phylogenetic theory and methods, thanks to many of you in this room, coupled with increasing availability of genomic scale data, has allowed biologists to achieve resolution for complex evolutionary histories that was previously unattainable. And so very briefly today, I'm going to highlight a case in which using these methods has recovered some interesting results, but still has left some questions unanswered. And so our system of study is the iconic baobab trees, or the genus Adansonia, which is comprised of 8 relatively clean recognized species. And previous phylogenetic analyses have found 3 distinct lineages based off geography seen here, so Africa, Madagascar, and Australia. But they were unable to resolve the relationship between these 3 lineages. And there were still some questions that remained about species relationships within some of the species of Madagascar. And so to address some of these lingering questions, we used a targeted sequence capture approach using custom bait set that allowed for recovery of hundreds of low copy nuclear loci. And so our first analysis was a Bayesian concordance analysis performed in Bucky to obtain a population tree shown here. And so this represents the dominant history of the taxa sampled, or otherwise thought of as the species tree. And so a couple of things that I just want to highlight from this tree is that even still, with almost 300 loci, we were unable to resolve the relationship between the Australian species and the rest of the genus. And so this concordance factor was insignificant. And so again, we were unable to resolve that relationship. I also want to point out that within Madagascar, some of the relationships that were previously thought to be monophyletic has now changed. And so you can see here, I've color-coded 2 clades in green. The 4 species that are labeled in dark green here were previously thought to be monophyletic, and now they are not. Okay, so we know there's a lot of incomplete lineage sorting on many of these branches, but we still don't know if there's other biological processes at play here, such as hybridization. And so to specifically test that, we used the program Ticker, which tests your data against 3 different models: panmixia, a perfect tree-like structure, or something in between, a partial tree-like structure with some periods of panmictic events or gene flow. And so Ticker rejects a tree, suggesting that there is some evidence of hybridization or gene flow between lineages. And so to further look at exactly where on the tree that could have occurred, we used the program SNAP. And so we tested for several different hybridization events, and we were able to recover 1 hybridization event that occurred relatively deep in time. So there is a hybridization event that accounted for relatively 8.5% of our genes analyzed from the African species into one of the Australian species, from the African species into one of the Madagascar clades. Okay, we were not expecting this result at all. And biologically, though, this does make sense. So this could account for some of the observed floral homoplasia within the group. Okay, so very interesting, but I do have some words of caution for biologists out there that are using some of these approaches. So first of all, these networks can yield very interesting results, but the Ticker test only rejected a tree-like structure with only a minor excess outlier of quartet, and so very mildly rejecting tree-like structure. Secondly, our SNAP hybridization event was only recovered in 52% of the bootstrap replicates. So, interesting, but perhaps not significant yet. And third point, we can't be sure, at least yet anyway, if we're accurately distinguishing between alleles and paralogous genes. And so, I again encourage you to utilize these methods, but interpret your results with caution. And so, with that, I would like to thank many of my co-authors and other people at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Thank you.